VA already we have marked it, it is here. VB is marked somewhere here. So the VA and VB we have, and its component along the transmission means whatever the common normal is drawn here. This is the common normal. Along that, whatever the CF is there, CF must be remain the same. Otherwise, there would be a mismatch and vibrations and other velocity will come into the picture. For that, and another thing is that here whatever be the, this one is a alpha, how the alpha is there, you can see here in the triangle OA, D and C. One can observe here in OA, D and C, this one is angle alpha, here this one is angle alpha, and after that D and C is there. So this one is another angle, and perpendicular to that, here we have a perpendicular. So this angle is again may be considered at whatever be the 90 minus this angle is there, it may be taken as a alpha. So this angle is also alpha. Similarly, if total angle here it is a beta, so the beta angle is somewhere here. It is with the symmetry one. So angle beta is here, angle alpha is there, its cos component would be there, that is along the normal. So here we have what we have observed here, I am writing it here, that resolving VA and VB along normal. NM. So what we have VA cos alpha, that must be equal to VB cos beta. Now we have OADC. Now we are considering the triangle OADC. So here what we are considering it here, that cos alpha OAD by OB into C. And from this equation, that here it is a first equation is there. So it can be also written as first one. We can put the value of a VA, VA and VB. In that case, VA is nothing but we can say whatever be the angular velocity is there, multiply by the distance OA into C. Similarly, VB is also omega B into OB into C. So from in equation 1, if we are putting these two values omega VA and VB, what we have? We have simply omega A multiply by OA multiply by the again whatever be the distance cos alpha was there, cos alpha, that must be equal to omega B into OB, the distance OBC multiply by the angle, that is a cos beta. So finally, we have a cos alpha. This terminology has a cos alpha and cos beta. Now we have to consider the cos alpha. For the cos alpha and cos beta, in triangle OADC. Now here I am considering this one angle, triangle OADC. Already we have taken there. From there, the cos alpha is equal to OAD upon OB into C. Similarly, triangle OBENC. This is cos beta. This provide cos beta, and that is equal to OBE upon OB into C. Now we have a two values, cos alpha and cos beta. If we are substituting it into the equation 2, let this one is equation 2, then we have omega A into OA into C into OAD upon OAC, and that must be equal to whatever the angular velocity of another one is there into the OB into C into OB into E upon OB into C. So now cancel it out. We have simply omega A upon omega B. This is equal to OBE upon OA into D. Now again OBE. Now we are considering the two similar triangles, that is the first one, that OACP, that we can mention it here OA, the center of rotation of first one, another one is the point P is here, PC. For the another, it is OBE and P. Both are the similar triangles. Here one angle is here, that is a vertically opposite, another one, it is a 90 degree, again here it is a 90 degree OA, D and C. So here one is a 90 degree, another 90 degree is here, angle at the P, that is a similar one, and here the point is there. So the another triangle means both these two triangles would be similar one. So here we can say that OBE upon OAD, that is equal to OBP and OA OAP. So our final expression is omega A upon omega B, that is equal to OBP and OAP. What does it shows? Means angular velocity of a first one with respect to the angular velocity of the second one, that is the point that is intersecting with the common normal with the center joining line in inverse ratio, means omega A by omega B, and here we have a P, and P point is located in between OA and OB in such a way that is in inverse ratio of the angular velocity. So here the law of gearing. So law of gearing is states that we have a profile, the mating tooth have a profile or it has a surface in such a way that is its common normal must pass through a point that joining the centers of the driving wheels and driven wheels at a point P, that point is known as a pitch point. And this pitch point divides in inverse ratio of the angular velocity of rotation. So here the law of gearing states that means what does it shows? It shows that we have a two centers of rotation of the gear wheels and a line joining to it has a point from where common normal passes at the point of a contact of a two wheels, and that point is known as a pitch point, and that pitch point is located at the inverse ratio of the angular velocity of the wheels. Means whatever the angular velocity is there, omega A upon omega B is the inverse ratio of the distance from their point. So also you can see that the velocity ratio at that instant, at that point of contact, the normal must pass through the pitch point, and that pitch point must divide the center line in inverse ratio of their angular velocity. So here generally we are taking two profiles, one is a involute, another one is a cycloidal one, that have a tendency to transmit the motion along the normal, as well as the third type that anyone can form the tooth profile in such a way that its normal may pass through the pitch point, that may be a conjugate type of profile. So involute is there, conjugate profile is there, and cycloidal profile is there for transmitting the motion through gear wheels. Now we are coming on the velocity of sliding. So the velocity of a slide, already I have told you this velocity VB and VA, VA and VB, we have two velocities and it has two components. One component is along the normal and another one is along the tangent. For the tangent component, whatever be the along the tangent, whatever the projections are there on the tangent, means here we have to draw in perpendicular directions. Actually this distance must be equal to the this distance. So there is a difference between both the components. So its component along the tangent is providing us a sliding velocity. Here we can observe that the velocity of sliding is the relative velocity of the mating teeth of a pair of gears at their point of contact in the direction of their common tangent. Common tangent we have drawn here, the common tangent at the point of contact, this one is. So for the first gear wheel we have a velocity VA along the TJ, means tangent, we have velocity that is VA sin alpha. Similarly here for the component of a VB in the direction of the common tangent TG is equal to VB sin beta. So, the sin alpha and sin beta is a component of the velocity along the tangent. Along the normal, we have a cos component. So, the cos component is responsible for the transmitting of the force, that is in the direction of the driving one, that is a tangential one at that point, means to the both the circles, that is one is driving, another one is driving. So, the normal is meant for transmitting the motion. Another component that we have taken, that is a sine component, that is along the tangent, and that tangent there the slipping will take place, sliding would be there. Sliding in the sense that one has a more velocity, another teeth has a less velocity, and there is the difference, and that difference is VA sin alpha and VB sin beta, as we have already seen here. Now, the relative velocity of a sliding of the body with respect to body B with respect to A, that is already we have seen that VB sin beta minus VA sin alpha. Now, again just put the value of a VB. VB is nothing but we can say that VB is omega B into the OB into the C. So, here the component means whatever be the distance is there multiply by the angular velocity for the first gear, another one is whatever the angular velocity multiply by the distance of a point of contact to the center of a rotation, that is the velocities at that point. So, what we can just put the value, after putting the value omega B into OB into C, sin beta is there and here we have a sin alpha, means omega A into OA into C, that is the velocity, that is the value of VB and VA.